Recording in progress.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to our Nigunim class, our weekly meeting to learn about Nigun, about the world of Nigun. It's such a nice, amazing, big world. There's so much to learn, and there's so much to sing, and it's endless. There's so many things. Thank you, Ayala, for being with us. I hope you stay for the next one also. So now we got a plea to dedicate this meeting Lilu Nishmat Bilha Bat Devora Ve'Avraham. So that let's let her have an Aliyat Neshama. And let's start with a song. So I want to start. Yeah, I didn't check in between classes. I should have checked. What's the third nigun in Chabad for Hineh Matov? There's two nigunim in Chabad for Hineh Matov. The third one I don't remember. I have to listen to it to remember it. But let's sing. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. If you hear, it's probably an Oriental nigun that got into Chabad. I combine two of the Oriental ones, and make them one. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Tidararai, tidararai. Ay, 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 na, 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 na. Ay, 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 na, 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 na. Ay, 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 na, na, na. Ay, 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 na, na, na. Da 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 da. Maybe the third one I'm looking for, and I just because I connected two nigunim, I made the one. We'll check for another time. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Tidadadai, tidadai, 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 tidadai. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Hineh Matov umana ha'im shehevet ha'chihim gam yahachad. Tidayara na 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 ya. Hineh Matov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. Hineh Matov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. Tire ya na 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 ya ya ya. Tire ya na 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 na. Ya na 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 na. Ay 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 ay. And as a known nigun amami, the folk song that everybody knows, I don't know what the origin is. Hineh Matov umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. 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 Hineh Matov לפניים שבט אחים, שבט אחים גם יחד, הנה מה טוב ומה נעים, שבט אחים גם יחד, הנה מה טוב ומה נעים, שבט אחים גם יחד, הנה מה טוב ומה נעים, שבט אחים גם יחד, הנה מה טוב ומה נעים, שבט אחים גם יחד. Now, the other nigun that I do remember for Chabad, I wanted to tell you the numbers. There's some people that like to follow the numbers of the nigunim. Where's my piece of paper? Now I lost my piece of paper. Here it is. Okay. So one nigun is 252 and 253. There's two nigunim here of Hine Matov. So the other one is a very simple song, not as simple as the one we just did, but still, it's very simple. It's a major. You could think that having Ahavat Yisrael is an ideal of people are good friends, and they have Ahavat Yisrael, and are good neighbors, and living together all the time, and everything is fine. No fights, everything is good. But that's not a true deep meaning of Ahavat Yisrael. Ahavat Yisrael is even somebody that you don't agree with, and you don't get along with, and you're fighting with, and you still have to love him. Like they say in Tanya, Perek Lamed Bet. You know that Lag BaOmer is the middle of, it's not exactly the middle, it's the heart of Sfirat HaOmer, because Lag is 33. We have Lev days before that, 32, which is the heart days before that, and Tov days from then on. So which means Lag BaOmer represents Lev Tov, having a good heart. So we have to love our friends with a good heart, if we agree with them or not. Like they say in the Tanya, Perek Lamed Bet, the Alter Rebbe says that if somebody that you're supposed to hate because he's doing so many bad things, and the Gemara says there's a mitzvah to hate somebody who's so wicked, and even that person, he says that there can't be, but even if there was a person like that you have to hate him, you still have to love him at the same time. So loving is everybody. So now this nigun that pretends to be like a very simple, happy tune, the third part goes into the cloudy area saying, wait a minute, and if things don't work out and we don't get along, we still have to be friends. So listen to it. 293, I think. No, 293. I don't have it open. Hine mato umanaim shevet achim gam yachad. 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 הנה מתו ומיה, אם אשבת אך, אם גם יחד. So, did you feel it? The third part is like a little cloudy, and we still have love, which is beautiful. Now let's do another simple one from Rav Ginsburg. He composed it 2 years ago on Lag BaOmer. We said Lev Tov, so to have a good heart. It's connected with Matan Torah, it's connected with our Parsha. That's why I brought the Hine Matov right now. So here's this beautiful Nigun from Rav Ginsburg. And it starts, wait a minute, I have to remember. Hine Matov Umanaim Shevet Achim Gam Yachad Hine Matov Umanaim Shevet Achim Gam Yachad Hine Matov Umanaim Shevet Achim Gam Yachad Hine Matov Umanaim שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מתו ומנעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מתו ומנעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מתו ומנעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד. Do you know it enough to sing with me? הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד הנה מה טוב ומה נעים שבת אחים גם יחד. So how is it connected with the Parsha and how is it connected with Matan Torah? So Parshat Bamidbar, we're going to celebrate Rosh Chodesh Sivan next week. And about Rosh Chodesh Sivan, the Torah says that on the day of Rosh Chodesh Sivan, Vayichan Yisrael tachat ahar, Ba'u Midbar Sinai, Vayichan Sham Yisrael tachat ahar. It's not from our parsha, but it's talking about Matan Torah, that we arrived in the Midbar, we arrived in the wilderness, in the desert, we arrived on the first day of Sivan, ויחן שם ישראל תחת ההר, ויחן, we had a camp there, and Rashi already brings, you know, the commentaries say, כאיש אחד בלב אחד, like one person with one heart. So that was the precondition, prerequisite situation we had to be in order to get to receive the Torah. Without Avat Israel, we couldn't receive the Torah. So we need the Avat Israel for that. Maybe we'll sing this song of Ke'ish Echad Belev Echad, a nigun of the like by the Rav Kaliv Rebbe, Rabbi Menachem Mendel of Kaliv, the one that passed away a few years ago. So he composed this one. It has words in Yiddish that I didn't write them down, so I can't read them out to you in Yiddish. But they're talking about let's get ready for the special occasion. No, all the Yidden should be get ready for the special occasion. Lekabalat HaTorah, the occasion of receiving the Torah, Lekabalat HaTorah. And the second time he goes through, he says, "Lekabalat pnei Mashiach tzedkenu." We should get ready for Gilkavelim pnei Mashiach. We should be ready to get Mashiach. And then he sings. The course is Torah miSinai. The Torah is from the Sinai. Not many words, so you can. I translate it in Hebrew. Ke'ish echad belev echad. Like we said, you know, when he got to Sinai, Ke'ish echad belev echad, lekabalat haTorah, Torah miSinai. כאיש אחד בלב אחד, כאיש אחד בלב אחד, בקבלת, לקבלת, בקבלת התורה, היי, בקבלת, בקבלת, בקבלת התורה. תורה תורה מסיני, 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 תורה תורה מסיני. כאיש אחד בלב אחד, כאיש אחד בלב אחד, בקבלת, לקבלת, לקבלת התורה, לקבלת, לקבלת, בני משיח צדקנו. תורה תורה מסיני, 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 תורה תורה מסיני. כאיש אחד בלב אחד, כאיש אחד בלב אחד, לקבלת, לקבלת, לקבלת התורה, לקבלת, לקבלת, פני משיח צדקנו. תורה תורה מסיני, 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 תורה תורה מסיני. תשיג לקבלת, לקבלת, פני משיח צדקנו. לקבלת, לקבלת, פני משיח צדקנו. תורה תורה מסיני, 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 תורה תורה מסיני. I just didn't remember if I did say לקבלת פני משיח צדקנו. I think naturally I sing both. So that's a cute one by the Caliber Rebbe. And yeah, the achdut, the love between the Jews is the prerequisite in order to receive the Torah. Now, the Torah was given in the desert. Why was the Torah given in the desert? That's part of our getting ready for Matan Torah. Understanding that our parsha, talking about the desert, is also connected. Last week we had the Har Sinai. This week is the desert. And next week we're already receiving the Torah. So that's interesting. So what's special about the desert, about the wilderness? First of all, it's a very humble place. It doesn't pretend to be a special, you know, especially fertilized or especially cultivated or especially nothing. It's a wilderness. Simple. It's modesty, to be modest. The other reason is that Midbar, the wilderness, the desert, doesn't belong to anybody. It's Hefker. It belongs to everybody. Because it doesn't belong to somebody, it belongs to everybody. That nobody can say, well, the Torah was out of reach for me, I couldn't be there. No, the Torah was given in the desert. Desert belongs to everybody. Everybody can come and connect. Everybody does belong. So the Torah belongs to everybody. That's another lesson to learn from the Midbar. And Mimidbar Matana. And another thing that I take, the word Midbar is the same letters as Medaber. Medaber is level of speech. We know that the world was created in a few levels. The lowest is the inanimate world, where godliness is so concealed, it doesn't move, it's nothing. If we look carefully, if we take it into an electronic microscope of our days, which is so, I don't know, but today we have machines that can see particles, which is smaller than an atom. You see movement all the time. You can see that there's nothing that doesn't move. Even the inanimate is very animated. There's always Ratzova Shov. There's something there that is Ratzova Shov. That's the secret of music. We're going to get to it very soon. And so we have the Domem, then we have the Tzomech, the plants. The plant kingdom lives on the Domem. And it does have some movement. You know, it is based in the, it can't live without the earth, but it has movement and it grows, it develops. So that's the second level. Third level is higher than that. That's the animals. So the animal kingdom is already free to move, and it has some free choice. It can choose where to go, and it can choose what to eat and what not to eat, and it has will, and it has feelings. The plants probably also have feelings. Maybe the stones also have feelings. They say that in the world to come, in today, Bezal Hashem, when the Shiach comes, the stone must scream out to the person stepping on it, "Hey, you, Bolak, why are you step on me? Who gives you permission? Why are you higher than me?" And they say in Hasidut, you know, the person walks down the street and doesn't have holy thoughts with him and Hasidut and Torah with him, the stone is going to scream at him, "Who gives you permission to step on me?" But hopefully we are doing the right thing, so the physical world wants to serve us and to help us. So the animal world, the animals can move. They don't really have free choice, but they have a choice of to move here, to move there, to go here, to go there. They have some kind of choice. Then we have man. And man already has free will and he has choice. And the biggest difference between man and animal is speech. Animal has some communication, but not much. And man with a speech, he has such a developed language, and that's the beauty of man. That's what's called medaber. That's the higher level of medaber. And the higher than that is the level of to be a Jew. To be Jewish, you have another kind of neshama. You have another neshama, not just the neshama of a man. You have a neshama of Yehudi. And that's called the fifth level. So now, what's special about the medaber and the Yehudi compared to lower than that? Especially the Yehudi, that we have nefesh eloka mimal. We have a second soul, not just the soul of a living creature. We have a special soul that was blown into us by Ribono Shel Olam, katuv vayipach be'apav nishmat chayim. He blew into us, you know, like forced the air into us, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Neshama, which is a part of godliness that is within us all the time. And that's the nefesh elokit. When God created the man in Bereshit, it says vayipach be'apav nishmat chayim. He blew into him the living soul. And they asked, what's living soul? Nishmat chayim, vayipach be'apav nishmat chayim. And the translation says ruach memalela. The power of speech. Lemalel is to talk. Ruach memalela. He gave him the soul that can talk. But still, the nefesh chaya, v'yadam nefesh chaya, there's chaya, there's yechida, there's a lot of secrets there. And so he blew into us the Holy Spirit, the Holy Nefesh Elokit. And all our life in this world, we are combined from two extreme worlds. We have a body that looks like the body of any other creature in the world, any other man in the world, and we have inside of it a concealed spirit which is higher than the whole world. Because there's godliness in the world that is concealed in the world, and you can't see it, but it's there. And we also have it. So it's like the godliness and the world. We have this, our neshama and the body. So what should we sing for that? I don't know. Too much talk. But let's get to something to sing. Let's sing something about the midbar. And then we'll talk more about Ruach Memalada, about this Ratzov Ashov, about the power of music, about the secret of electricity, Hashmal. So let's sing Ko Amar Hashem. Ko Amar Hashem. It's an old melody. I don't know whose. If anybody knows where it comes from, we'll be very happy to find out. Ko Amar, Ko Amar Hashem, Zacharati Lach, Chesed Nehuraich, Ahavat Kelulot Ahayich, Ahavat Kelulot Ahayich, Lech Tehech Acharai, Acharai, Bamidbar Be'eret, Lo Zeruah, Lech Tehech Acharai, Acharai, Bamidbar Be'eret, Lo Zeruah. Ko amar Hashem zacharti lach chesed neuraich ahavat kelulotayich lechtech acharai acharai bamidbar be'eretz lo zeruah lechtech acharai acharai bamidbar be'eretz lo zeruah. Ko amar Hashem zacharti lach chesed nehuraich ahavat kelulotayich ahavat kelulotayich lechtech acharai acharai bamidbar be'eretz lo zeruah lechtech acharai acharai bamidbar be'eretz lo zeruah. You know the song? There's another one maybe more famous. a newer one by Rabbi Chaim Bennett. I think it's a Belzer Chassid. And he also have the same words, Ko Amar Hashem, that's what says Hashem, Zacharti Lach Chesed Nuraich. I remember your favor that you did with me when you were young, that you went with me into the desert. You know, we're going to marry Ribbono Shel Olam. Next week is the wedding. So are you ready for the wedding? We're going to marry Ribbono Shel Olam. So let's sing this other one. Ko Amar, Ko Amar Hashem, Zacharti Lach Chesed Nuraich. Ahavat kelulotayich, ahavat kelulotayich. Ko amar, ko amar Hashem, zacharti lahachesed nehurayich. Ahavat kelulotayich. Ahavat kelulotayich. Lechtech acharai bamidbar. Be'eretz lo zeruha. Lechtech acharai bamidbar. Be'eretz lo zeruha. Lechtech acharai bamidbar, be'eretz lo zeruha. Lechtech acharai bamidbar, be'eretz lo zeruha. Ko amar, ko amar Hashem. Zacharti lahachesed nehurayich. Ahavat kelulotayich. Ahavat kelulotayich. Lechtech acharai bamidbar. Be'eretz lo zeruha. Lechamtech acharai bamidbar, be'eretz lo zeruha. Lechtech acharai bamidbar, be'eretz lo zeruha. Lechtech acharai bamidbar. Be'eretz lo zeruha. Beautiful, beautiful niggun, full of feeling. I said I'm going to talk a little about the secret of electricity, of chashmal, that is connected with Matan Torah and with the kolot, because in Matan Torah we have such a big thing about kolot. We could see the voices, could see the sound, and couldn't hear the view. There was a interchange between all the senses, because the senses, we got higher up than the separating between the different senses. So it's kalelut, yeah. So, we're talking about the secret of electricity. Secret of electricity, hashmal in Hebrew, by chance. They chose the word in the modern Hebrew for chashmal, as meaning electricity. But in the Torah, in the Nevi'im, in the prophets, we have the word electricity showing up in the Sefer Yechezkel. When Yechezkel had the vision of seeing godliness, like we're all going to see B'zad Hashem on Shavuot, because it's a repetition of what we saw in Matan Torah. So seeing godliness, you know, he saw Ke'in chashmal. What's chashmal? So the commentator says it's connected with the holy chariot and the holy spirits and the holy angels and all these powers of spiritual powers, and these special spirits up there, the chayot hakodesh itim chashot, itim mimalulot. Sometimes they're silent, and sometimes they talk. Itim chashot, itim mimalulot. yes and no, yes and no, yes and no, yes and no. That's the beginning of movement, right? That's, electricity is this. We spoke about the atom and about the looking with the movement. Even in the inanimate, there's always movement. This world is built on sound. Hashem created the world with asara ma'amarot. That's the way He created the world. And ma'amar is speech. So there's speech and there's silence. And the word chashmal is made out of two words. Chash, itim chashot, is to be silent. Lachashot is to freeze, to be silent. And memalelot, lemalel, mal, is a word. Mila, mila besela, mashtuka betrei. Itim chashot, mi yimalel gvorot Hashem. Mi yimalel gvorot Hashem yashmiya. כל תהילתו מי ימל אל גבורות השם ישמיע כל תהילתו מי ימל אל גבורות השם ישמיע כל תהילתו מי ימל אל גבורות השם ישמיע כל תהילתו אשרי שומרי מצווה עושי צדק בכל עת אשרי שומרי מצווה עושי צדק בכל עת אשרי שומרי מצווה עושה צדקה בכל עת אשרי שומרי מצווה עושה צדקה בכל עת אני אגיד מרב גינסבורג just to cut the speech which is too long so the world was created with sound because we said that he had an nefesh chaya when he made man he put the spirit into him, and then he became a living creature. So living, something the Chazal say, our sages say, kol chai mitno'ea, whatever is alive moves. If it's alive, it has to move, because life is connected with movement. If you look at our body and our world, everything has this ratzo v'shov, yes and no, back and forth. Our heartbeat, our breathing, day and night, seasons, the ocean, everything is built on movement. And inside of the most little particle, there's a movement of the particles all the time, there's movement. And the atom that has electricity in there, the yes and no, yes and no. So, chashot and memalelot, itim chashot, itim memalelot, yes and no, yes and no. They say, mila besela, mashtuka betrei. A word is worth one coin, and silence is worth two. Why? Why is silence more important than speech? If a word is worth one, and silence is worth two. So first of all, if you're silent, they might think you're smart. So it's better to be silent than to talk. So maybe, you know, they'll think you're smart. But there's more reason. There's something inside of us, in our heart, that is the concealed world and our inner world, they say that liva puma lo galia. There's some things in our heart that the heart can't speak out, can't tell to the mouth. It stays inside, it's hidden, it's the concealed. That's the silence, it's inside. Outside, the speech. When you speak out, you say things, that's the outside world. So a liba, the puma, that's the pe. They say in the future, we're going to be able to reveal the inside song. The inside voices, okay, so there's silence and a speech, but there's something in between, silent speech, and that's music. I like to ask, you know, if a word is one coin and the silence is two, how much is music? So you would say 10, 100, 1,000, a million, endless. But our sages teach that this in between the silence, which is inside, and the speech, there's a simple voice, that's kol. And it sits on the border between the chash and the mal, and there's another mal there, like a brit milah, that's the voice, that sound, that cuts the silence, and, you know, to make a sound. So, where are we going from there? So, speech and silence and music. So music is in between. It's the secret of one and a half, the secret of electricity, and if you see, not by chance, the whole musical, Western musical scale is built on a half and whole step and a half step. If you want to read more about it, get the book, recommended. Music, the Quill of the Soul. came out not long ago, just before Pesach, by Rav Ginsburg. A lot of secrets revealed, a lot of what he teaches is from this book, and a lot of what he teaches is from the introduction to Sefer Nigunim, but that's already amazing, amazing stuff. Rachel Gordon edited the book, and beautiful, worth buying. So, we should sing. Can't talk too much. That's cool, the sound, and that's the desert, Medaber. So the Midbar and the Medaber. Midbar has both the desert and the person that speaks. And on Matan Torah, we get a covenant between us and godliness that can be a connection between the worlds, between the physical world and the spiritual world. So there will be a flow. Now, the connection connects with our topic of this week. I'm starting so late to talk about the topic of the week, but it's okay. We have enough time. We said that the sefira of the next language of song is Yesod. Yesod. Yesod is connection. That's what we're talking about, of connecting, you know, of making a bond, of making a brit, of making a covenant and uniting. That's connecting. That's Yesod. And the language of song for Yesod is bracha. Why bracha? Because bracha represents to bring down the plenty from above, to bring it down, to connect the spiritual world down to our world. What's berkaim, berech in Hebrew, is knees. To kneel down, when you bow down to the king, you kneel, right? That's the knees. You go down on your knees. The camel go down on the knees. In Hebrew, you call it lehavrich et agamal, to pull down the camel, lehavrich. It's like baruch atah Hashem. What's baruch atah Hashem? We say it so many times, we don't even think about what we say. Baruch, you, godliness, we're bringing you down into this world because of this mitzvah. You're being brought into the world. It's amazing. Every mitzvah we do, it's such a blessing. it's a big, big, bringing a lot of godliness and blessing into the world. So the language of bracha, of the Yesod, talking about connecting, also connects with the tzaddik. You know, the tzaddik represents it because brachot l'rosh tzaddik, the tzaddik is the vessel that brings down the plenty into the world. And bracha is pulling down the shefa, the plenty, into the world. So one of the best nigunim to see that is Berkat Kohanim. We have a bracha, you know, the Kohanim stand and they bless us, and they sing a song and they bring the blessing down into the world. So what melody do we have for Berkat Kohanim? So in Chabad we have a special melody for Berkat Kohanim, and it's very interesting. This melody was composed because the Mittler Rebbe asked for a new song for Berkat Kohanim and brought him many possibilities, and he didn't like any of them. Till they brought him this one we're going to sing now. That's what we're singing in Chabad. And he loved it. What's special about this melody? First of all, you can see the flow of the bracha coming down to the world. Mamash, you can hear it, you can see it. Almost visualize it, it's so tangible. Ay, 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 yevarech echa. Ay, 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 yevarech echa. Hashem, Hashem. Ay, 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 yam, da, 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 ay, 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 vishmerecha. Ay, 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 yam, da, 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 ay, ay, nam, vishmerecha. Ay, 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 yeah, and so on and so on. Ta-da-da-da, ya-na-ya-na-yam. What's special about this melody? There's a quote about this. I don't know where the quote is from. Maybe it's from Levitzan with Bedichev. That this melody might be from Beit HaMikdash. But how can it be from Beit HaMikdash? We just said it was composed by the time of the Mittler Rebbe. How can that be? So I solved that mystery. Hashem solved that mystery. Revealed it to me. One holiday that, you know, they were singing this melody in shul. It's so beautiful, see many Kohanim together sing the melody. And this poor Kohen was standing with his hands up for so long because the melody is so big, long. It takes a long time, and he didn't know it, and he couldn't sing with him. So he's standing there stuck with his hands out, and he's waiting and waiting. And when we get to the word, He joins them. Yevarechecha Hashem v'yishmerecha. What did I find out? Amazing. The ancient melody is hiding inside of the Chabad melody. All the ornaments around it, so beautiful, are just around the original words that everybody sings. I don't know about the Sephardic word, maybe. So maybe that is from Beit HaMikdash, and Chabad just, how to call it, wrapped it up in this beautiful. Ay 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 ay. There's also secret who stands in front of panim. You have to stand panim al panim. It's face to face. Some people turn their head away. That's not supposed to be. You're supposed to have your face to the kohanim to get bracha face to face, and a little to the right, a little to the left, and a little to the middle. Something it says in the books, according to the secret. But at least have the face. Shalom. Shalom. The last time, they repeat everything 3 times. Trying to say something? I couldn't read what you're saying.
How are you supposed to do their head during the prayer?
Face the Kohanim, first of all. But in the books, it says something a little to the right and to the middle and to the left. And I think by the Alter Rebbe in his books or something. So if you have it written in your machzor, okay. If not, just keep your face to them. I don't remember. There's some kind of, because the Kohanim also, they have the going right to left, sometimes here, sometimes there, but you can't see them because you don't watch. I'm just married to a Kohen, so I'll know a little bit about it. But it also says it in the books. Okay, so that's one song for Bracha. Another song for Bracha would be the melody that the Rebbe used to sing under the chuppah. And I don't know how he used to talk. The special sing-song used to say Bracha. Berkat of Sefirat HaOmer. Baruch Ata Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaOlam Asher Kedeshanu Mitzvotav Vetzivanu Lananaham Ayam Lananaham. Sounds a little bit also like the Berkat Kohanim melody we did. There's a sing-song kind of melody that the Rebbe used to say the brachas under the chuppah. So it's worth it. I'll try and find it. Remind me, I'll send it in the group. Now there's another beautiful song that Rav Ginsburg mentioned that probably shows us how bracha comes down. It's just to make say there. The niggun we sent before of Hine Mato was 252 or 253. I might have said the wrong number before. Hine Mato and Sefer Nigunim. There's also 106 in another Sefer Nigunim, which I have to check which one that is. Now, the niggun we're going to do now is 292. It's a niggun itvadut from Brengen Niggun. Some people say that it's from Rabbi Hillel of Parich. And it's a beautiful, but you can hear also it's coming down, coming down, coming down. Tine ay 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 ay. Ay 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 ay. Na 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 na, ay 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 ay. Again. The beautiful melody from maybe Rabbi Hillel of Parich. So that's another melody for Bracha. If we're talking about, you can hear also this nigun that comes up. Beautiful, beautiful. There's another nigun in Chabad that could be fitting for that. That's a maybe. I'm saying it myself. It's the nigun that we sing, la 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 la, the Shabbos and Yontov nigun. Which number is that? Ya da 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 ya ha ha ya ya 70 something, 90 something, what is it? I hey, no, it's the other book. Tire ya ha ha ya ma ha ha ya ma ya ya. You can also hear it's coming down. Ya da 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 ha ha ya ya. Tire ya ha ha ya. Somebody described one of the, I think some of the rabbeim, that you can hear the worlds this descending down to the worlds of the Atzilut Bri'ah Yetzirah Asiya, this world. Some people call this Nigun Atzilut Bri'ah Yetzirah Asiya. Ya da 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 ya ha ya ya. Today, ya da 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 ya da 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 ha ya ya ya. Ay da 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 da. Ay da 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 ya da 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 da. Ay da 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 ya ha ha ya ya. Ay da 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 ya da 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 ya. Ay da 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 ya da 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 da, ay da 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 ya da 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 da, ay da 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 ya ay ay ay, ah hey, ay 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 ya da 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 da, ay 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 ya da 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 da, ay 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 da 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 da. Ay da 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 da, ay ay ay, ay 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 ay, na 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 na, ay 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 ay, na 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 na, ay 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 ay, ay 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 ay, ay 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 ay, ay 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 ay, ay 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 ay, ay 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 ay. Na da 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 ya ha ya ma ya ya hey, So this beautiful nigun could also portray the coming down of the plenty into this world. Let's do song that has the word bracha in it. Barakot elachem bracha ad blidai. So this two nigunim in Chabad. Let's do the fast one first, this one, this time. It's nigun kuf samech 160. And the Rebbe said about it, it might be from the Alter Rebbe himself. It's at the time for the Alter Rebbe, it's ancient, but it could be that it was composed by the Alter Rebbe himself. And it's so well known all over the world. Vaikoti lachem bracha That's the fast one, and then there's a slower one that was composed by Rabbi Aaron Charitonov. Vaikoti lachem bracha, vaikoti lachem bracha, vaikoti lachem bracha, ad blidai, ad blidai, ad blidai, bracha, ad blidai. First it climbs up, it's from us going there, but then here it's coming down. Vaikoti lachem bracha. Vaikoti lachem bracha, vaikoti lachem bracha, ad blidai, ad blidai, ad blidai, bracha, ad blidai, ya na na na, ay na 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 na, ay ay na 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 na. Ay 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 na 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 ay 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 bracha al blida ay ay na 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 ay ay na 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 beshiu achshav ay ay na na ay 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 bracha al blida ay 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 na na ay 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 na 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 bracha al blida ta da 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 ay hey ay 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 na na ay na na ay 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 na bracha al blida ta da 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 ay 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 bracha al blida ya na 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 ay na 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 bracha al blida. That's the other melody for bracha, so beautiful. Rabbi Aaron Charitonov. Let's do a song connected with Yom Yerushalayim that comes next week. There's a song that the Rebbe asked to be put on a Chabad melody because he was talking a lot about Yerushalayim, how blessed Yerushalayim is going to be in the future. Bezal Hashem, today already, if not today, then tomorrow, that Yerushalayim is going to be in such a condition, it's going to be so safe, that it's going to be without a wall. It won't need a wall anymore. It's Prazot Teshev Yerushalayim. Yerushalayim is going to be free, and it's going to spread out to the whole Eretz Yisrael, and it's going to spread out to the whole of of the world. במהרה בימינו, שיבנה בית המקדש במהרה בימינו, ותן חלקנו בתורתך. 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 Next week, בבית המקדש, with a piano, with instruments. Next we're going to talk about Malchus, about getting ready for the Torah, and a lot of nigun about Torah, and about, yeah, we'll talk more about Matan Torah. Any questions? I'm going to end the session.
Thank you so much.
Vakasha, Carol, vakasha.